Okay, good morning, children. We are going to finish the topic basic concepts of immunology. This one we discussed in the yesterday itself. Once again, we will recollect the information. What is immunology? Immunology means what? The study of immune system. The study of immune system is called immunology. So this system protects the individual from various infective agents. So now what is this one? Okay, how it will be helpful for the what you call that one, we will discuss. Okay, so what will happen? The ability of the body, the overall ability of body to fight against the disease is called immunity. What is called immunity? So this one is also important point. Next, it is also called disease resistance. This is also called disease resistance. Next, most important point. So lack of immunity is known as lack of immunity is known as what is called susceptibility. Lack of immunity is called susceptibility. Next, the immunity is highly specific. Highly specific. This point you should have to remember. Okay, so now we have to think about the different types of immunities. That one we will be discussing. Okay, children. So now what we are going to discuss is immune diseases will become autoimmune diseases. What is autoimmune diseases? Self antibodies. Okay, own molecules. So some antibodies reacts destructively. That point you should have to remember. Destructively against the host's own molecule. Okay, own molecules. So what will happen? Our immune system cannot distinguish which one is foreign and which one is inside. That time what will happen? Some antibodies works against its own what is called molecule, kills that one. Such autoimmune diseases are such are called autoimmune diseases. It is fatal to the organism, dangerous to the organisms, fatal to the organisms. This point you should have to remember. Autoimmune diseases. Okay. So this immune system fail in the sense we will get so autoimmune diseases. Next, almost all the macromolecules. Okay, these all are called very very important. What you called proteins. Okay, proteins, polysaccharides, proteins, polysaccharides, nucleic acids. Okay, these all are foreign. Suppose foreign. Okay, children, observe very carefully. It is what you called foreign recipient organism. Recipient organism. Foreign recipient can induce the immune response. These are induces the which one? The immune responses. So which induces the immune responses. Okay, children. So that is very very important. These all are induces the immune responses. So next one, any substance, okay children, any substance capable of eliciting immune response. Eliciting immune response is called antigen. It's called antigen. So antigen is another term. What you can tell another term? It is antibody generator. It is also called antibody generators. So there are innate immunity and acquired immunity. The innate immunity table we discuss now. We are going to discuss about acquired immunity. What are the innate immunity characters? The types of innate immunity. What are the types of characters of innate immunity? That one you have to remember. Natural phenomenon. Okay, children, it's a very natural phenomenon of resistance to infection. Okay, this is resistance to infection. Okay, resistance to infection. Right from the birth, this immunity will be takes place in our body. Right from the birth, it is non-specific. So it will not a specific. Not specific. It will controls all the germs. Okay, non-specific. Okay, so this is helpful for. Okay, this is also called non-specific immunity. Non-specific immunity. Yesterday we discussed the table also barriers. Immunity are also called what you call this is also called natural immunity. This is also called what you called natural immunity. Now acquired immunity. Natural, okay. Next concept is acquired immunity. Acquired immunity. So this immunity individual acquires after the birth. After the birth, the individuals acquires. This one is important. Acquired. Okay. Acquires. That's why it is called acquired immunity. It's a body resistance to specific antigen. Body resistance to specific, this word you have to remember, specific antigen, specific antigen. Okay children, so this one we are going to discuss little bit later, but you should have to listen carefully what I am telling. Basic concepts of immunology. We are discussing basic concepts of immunology. What is immunology? The immunology means study of immunity. Okay, study of system protects the individual from various infective agents. The study of system protects the individual from various infective agents is called that's immunity or immunology. Overall ability of body to fight against the disease causing pathogen is called immunity. Overall ability of body to fight against the disease. Okay, if any disease is there, any pathogen entered and which causes the disease, in the sense the disease controlled by one specific system in our body, that is called immunity system. The study about immunology, immunity system, is only called immunology. The immunity system, another immunity is also called, another name is there for immunity, it is also called disease resistance. It is also called disease resistance power. So if suppose the person don't have the immunity, the person don't have immunity, lack of immunity is there, in the sense that person is called, known as lack of immunity in that person is there, in the sense that will be, that person is considered as very susceptibility, means easily will get the infection. Susceptibility, lack of immunity is known as susceptibility. Susceptibility in patients or the persons easily will get the infections. Now immunity is highly specific. Immunity is highly specific. So suppose any bacteria entered, bacteria related pathogen, antibodies will be formed and they will kill. So specific immunity will be there. And one more is there, autoimmune disease. It is very important. Sometimes our immunity only kill us, our immunity only damages. How sometimes our immune system, our antibodies reacts, destructs against the own, against the own molecules, against the which one, own molecules, then what will happen? Autoimmune diseases. For example, here I am writing example, rheumatoid arthritis. What do you call? Rheumatoid arthritis, one of the examples. What in this case? Our immunity cannot distinguish which one is foreign and which one is the internal, our own. That time what will happen? Our own antibodies will disrupt the our own molecules or antigens. That time this autoimmune disease problems will come. It is fatal to the, dangerous to the organisms. And here one speciality is there. Any protein, polysaccharides or nucleic acids, the foreign receptor of organisms induces the immune response. Anyone, either protein will induces the immunity, polysaccharides immunity induces the immunity, or nucleic acid also induces immunity responses or immune responses. So any substance capable of eliciting immune responses is called antigen. So whatever, either protein or polysaccharide, nucleic, whatever it may be, which will, what is called eliciting or activates the immune responses, immunity is called antigens. Or another name of antigen is called antibody generator, because antigen entered, in the sense immediately what will happen, antibody will be generated. So there are types of immunities there. There are types of, two types of immunities. Number one, innate immunity and acquired immunity. What do you call it? Innate immunity and acquired immunity. Innate immunity is a natural phenomena. It's a resistance we will get to infection right from birth. After birth immediately we will get the natural phenomena, this innate immunity. It's a non-specific. It's not only particular bacteria or not only particular fungi. It controls almost all microorganisms. That's why it is called non-specific immunity or natural immunity. So acquired immunity means after birth we will take the vaccines or not, or infections we will get through infection after our control curing of that in disease, we will get the resistance against to that particular disease, means that is acquired immunity. So body resistance specific, that's why the acquired immunity is called specific immunity, body resistance to specific antigen. So that's why the acquired immunity also called, what you called, specific immunity. What they will do, they will identify as the pathogen and kills the pathogen, and they will remember that pathogen information, like that immunological memory also will be there in the immunity. Okay children, now components of acquired immunity we will be discuss. Okay children, we will discuss about components of acquired immunity. Components of acquired immunity we will be discussing. The unique features, of acquired immunity. The unique feature of acquired immunity is number one, antigenic. What is called? Antigenic specificity. Antigenic specificity. First one. Number two, diversity. Number three, recalled recognition of recognition of self and non-self and immunological and what you call immunological memory. Memory. These are the components of or features of acquired immunity. Antigen specificity, diversity, they will identify, they will identify different antigens they will catch, and recognition, which one is self, which one is non-self, is under control of acquired immunity, and immunological memory also. So that is related to that infection, they will be remember also. That is the features of acquired immunity. Those are the features of acquired immunity. Now next concept, what the components of acquired immunity. First one, CMI. What is the CMI? Cell mediated. What is called? Cell mediated immunity. Okay children, cell mediated immunity. Second one, antibody mediated immunity. Cell mediated immunity and antibody mediated immunity. First one, cell mediated immunity we discuss. The cell mediated immunity, when pathogens destroyed by cells, the pathogens are destroyed by cells without producing antibodies, then it is known as cell mediated immune response. Cell mediated immune response, or what we called cell mediated immunity. okay children, without antibodies immune cells only will destroys the pathogen. This is brought about by then who, which type of immune cells? T cells. Number two, macrophages. Macrophages. Number three, natural, what you called, natural killer cells. Okay children, like this, cell mediated immunity under control of these cells. Okay, second one, antibody mediated immunity. What you called, antibody mediated immunity. What is antibody mediated immunity? When the pathogens are pathogens as it is destroyed by, okay, pathogens destroyed by which one? The antibodies. Pathogens are destroyed by antibodies, then that kind of immunity is called antibody immunity. This is also called humoral immunity. This kind of immunity is called, what you call this kind of immunity, is called humoral immunity. So who will be, B cells will be involved in this kind of immunity with the help of B cells and with the help of antigen presenting cells. Antigen presenting cells. Okay children, antigen presenting cells and T helper cells. Okay, T helper cells, by the help of these two, what they will helpful for the antibody production. Antibody T helper cells, this one you have to remember, antibody production. Okay, antibody production will be there. Is a, this is the future of characteristic future. Characteristic, what you call characteristic future of, future of vertebrates. Characteristic futures of which one? Vertebrates. This point also can you have to, you have to remember. Okay children, what we are discussing we have to see now. So innate immunity, acquired immunity, innate immunity tables we discussed, active immunity or passive immunity, we are the types of immunities are there. So now one more thing, important thing what we have to do is you have to observe very carefully the different, what you called, features of acquired immunity. The unique feature of acquired immunity are their antigenic specificity. So they will particular antigen only, they will, that immunity will be act. So it shows the diversity also, different different forms it will shows. Recognition of self and non-self. So which one is self cells, which one is non-self is recognized by acquired immunity. So and also very important, so that is the special feature of acquired immunity is it will performs the immunological memory. So which remembers the particular disease causing agent, that is a capacity of acquired immunity. Now components of acquired immunity, there are two components are in the acquired immunity. Number one, CMI. What is the CMI? Cell mediated immunity. Number two, antibody mediated immunity. Cell, in the name itself answer is there. To control the pathogens, okay, with the only destroyed by cells without producing antibodies. Again, I'm repeating this point. Cell mediated immunity, the pathogens are destroyed by cells without producing antibodies. Without producing antibodies is there, in the sense that kind of immunity is called cell mediated immunity. It is also known as cell mediated response or cell mediated immunity. Next, which cells mainly involve in the T cell mediated immunity? T cells, macrophages and natural killer cells, neat bit. Okay, which one is involved in the, which one, cell mediated immunity? T cells, macrophages and natural killer cells. Then antibody mediated. So suppose the pathogen destroyed by antibodies, okay, that is called antibody immunity, also called humoral immunity. So B cells only produce antibodies by the help of antigen presenting cells and T helper cells. Again, I'm repeating this point. By the help of antigen presenting cells and helper cells, B cells only produce the antibodies. These antibodies only kills the germs. So antibody production, against to that pathogen is a characteristic feature of vertebrates. So antibody production is the characteristic feature of vertebrates. Okay children, that is also one more important point. Next one, the immunological resistance. So mainly we are going to discuss about that immunological some more characters. Immunological characters we are going to discuss. Okay children, first one, immunization. What is immunization? We are going to discuss immunization. Okay children, immunization. Okay, acquired immunity, active immunity. What do you call active immunity? What it will do is acquired through is acquired. Active immunity is acquired through, okay children, acquired through the use of a person's okay, a person's immune responses. Active immunity is acquired through the uses of a person's acquired immune responses. Okay, so this is the most important, which lead to development of memory cells. So this is a very important, this memory cells. So active immunity results from an infection. Active immunity, okay, results from an infection, or an immunization. So this point you have to remember. Okay children, what is the immunization? They have memory cells or not? So active immunity is acquired through the use of a person's immune response, which leads to development of memory cells. See, these memory cells, any same particular parasite entered, means these memory cells produce antibodies and kills the germs. That kind of mechanism, the person is getting memory cells and developing immunity or not, that process called immunization. The active immunity results, what will happen, from an infection or immunization. So when you give the person immunity or any, what you call, vaccine you give, immunization means nothing but what, vaccines you give, in the sense that fellow will get immunity against to the disease. So getting again immunity against to the disease, in the sense, that is called immunization. Or suppose by the help of infection, suppose smallpox is there. Here I am giving examples. Smallpox virus. This smallpox virus enter into the person's body, right? Then person's body will produce the immunity. Okay. So this immunity produces some memory cells, you know very well. And what you call antibodies like this. So when this virus entered, these all antibodies, okay, antibodies kills the, which one, the virus. Now this fellow got the disease free, but after some day these antibodies will be like that only, so will be stay in our, in that person's body. Same smallpox virus second time entered means, so these are fastly, first time very slowly, fastly they reduces the, kills the, that particular virus by antibodies. Like this, the person through the infection getting immunity or not, that is called, that process is only called, what you called, immunization. What you called, immunization. Why? Because they have memory cells. Okay, next, vaccines. For example, one fellow took the polio vaccine. Okay, polio vaccine means nothing but inactive polio virus particle only. So given, so then body will produce which one, antibodies against to the polio vaccine, polio virus. Now after some days, original for or active polio virus entered, in the sense this all will be there already. They produce kills the polio virus. This kind of development of immunity is only called development of immunity in the person by the infection only called, what you call, that is called immunization. Okay children, thank you children. Next class tomorrow we will continue with some more contents in the immunology. Thank you.